We started out nice today. I talked about this in the newsletter this past weekend that we would likely have an end of the month rally. We were very oversold. There was some positioning that needed to be done by major mutual funds, hedge funds, et cetera, by the end of October. The first month, the first day of the month, November the 1st being today, tends to also be a positive day in the markets, positions trying to be put on for the month. And particularly after such a bad month in October, people are just a little bit hopeful here that we're now entering into the seasonally strong period of the year. We'll get a little bit of pickup in the market, and that may very well be the case. But as I'm going to talk about in a moment with Michael Leibowitz, that may not actually be the outcome that we get. So we want to be a little bit cautious here. We've talked about raising some cash over the last few days, using this rally to do so. And this is a weekly chart of the S&P 500. And what you see here is that we are now running back up against this long-term moving average that we violated just a couple of weeks ago. Now, this is the first time we've actually violated this moving average over the last couple of years. And again, we kind of messed around with it earlier this year, but really held on to it, rallied to new highs in September. But this is the first serious break of this moving average. So a rally back here, about another 30 points from where we are. We could see that tomorrow. If Apple's earnings are good today after the bell, we could very well see a pop tomorrow. That would put us right up underneath this moving average. Use that average, take a little bit of money off the table. It's still too soon to call the bull market back in town. If you've been caught up in this recent sell-off, this is a great opportunity to reduce some risk, rebalance risk in your portfolios, and then make some decisions about what you want to do next. But again, this rally that we're getting is likely a gift. There's still a lot of things out there right now that suggest that we have actually started a more negative trend in the market, at least for the next several months.